My name is Lindsay and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be doing a makeup collection organization and storage video. This video was very, very requested. I don't know about you, but I am big on organization. I like for everything to be in its place and I like knowing where everything is. My makeup, I buy all myself and it's extremely valuable, so I like to treat it well, make sure that it's stored properly and safely. Before I continue on, I want to give a quick shout out to my little sister Gabby. I was told that she watches my videos and has been keeping up, so hello Gabby, I love you, I miss you, how are you doing? I want to do a quick disclaimer. I am not trying to brag, I am not trying to show off any of the makeup that I have. I buy all my makeup and beauty products with my own money, and I work very hard to do so. So if you are someone who is going to be offended, or if you are someone who is going to be upset in any way by this video, please click away. It won't hurt my feelings at all if you decide that this is not the video for you. For those of you who would like to see it, I appreciate you and I am so flattered by your interest. Without further ado, let's get into the video. So in my husband and I's bedroom, we have a half bathroom, and in the half bathroom is this closet. And the closet has about four shelves. I'm only showing you the two shelves I use for my beauty products, and I'll get a close up in a second and I'll go through kind of the products that I have. But this is what it looks like when you walk in. Starting off with my makeup shelf, I have two little cards from ColourPop. Every time you order from ColourPop, they send you an adorable little postcard looking thing. So these are just two that I have. As you can see, I have all my makeup stored right here. Just a quick overview. Up here, I have more health and beauty related items. I'll just give you a quick overview. I'm starting off with my beauty products that I use every day. This is my makeup bag and my brush holder. And underneath it all, we have my beloved Jaclyn Hill palette. You guys know that I love and adore it. So first I'm gonna go through each bag and show you kind of the everyday products that I use. Starting off with one of my favorite highlighter palettes ever. This is my Jaclyn Hill highlighter palette. I got the one for lighter skin tones. So as you can see, it comes with four gorgeous highlighters, and my nail accidentally hit this. So if you're wondering what that is, my bad. Next, I have my Revolution Luxury Baking Powder in Ghost White. I use this to set my under eyes and I absolutely love it. Then I have my Becca Ultimate Coverage 24-Hour Foundation, my Flower Beauty Seal the Deal Hydrating Setting Spray. I use this as a primer. Next, I have my Jaclyn Hill highlighter in the color Do Me. This is her Luminous Powder. I love this. I set my face with it. Next, I have my very well used and very loved Milani Baked Blush in the color Dulce Pink. And I have my NYX Professional Makeup Eye Primer in the color White or Blanc, however you want to say it. And you guys have seen me use this palette 1,000 times, but I'll just show you it again. As you can see, it's very well used and very loved. Moving on to brushes, I have my everyday brushes laid out for you here. This is my Sonia Kashuk little dense brush. I will sometimes use this for bronzer or contour. Sometimes I'll use it for blush. It just depends. There are no rules with makeup brushes. I have this brush I actually got from Marshall's. I don't remember the brand name. As you can see, it's completely rubbed off. If I can find it, I'll link it below. But this is a flat top brush that I use for buffing in foundation. This big fat fluffy brush is from Sonia Kashuk. I use it for blush. I can use it for all over face powder. It just depends on the day, the mood. Now this is an EcoTools dual ended brush. I use this so much, you guys. I have to clean it constantly, which is kind of annoying, but I don't know what I would do without this brush. This end I use for blending under eye colors, and this fluffy side I use for applying color to the crease. I don't use this for blending, but it is great for kind of applying the color, and you can use a blending brush to blend it all in. This brush is very dirty and very well used, but it is from Wet n Wild. I love this brush. It is perfect for blending, and I use it to blend my crease, my under eyes, and sometimes I'll use it for setting my under eyes. Now, this is my Sonia Kashuk eyebrow brush. It comes with a brush on one end and a spoolie on the other. This is so perfect. It's very kind of stiff, so it works great to get your eyebrows filled in. And the spoolie, I don't know how, but it's really hard to get it dirty. I love that about this brush. Now, I have two Real Techniques brushes that are exactly the same. These are called their setting brushes, and as you can see, it has a little piece of tape on the end. This is how I kind of differentiate between the two. This brush with the tape on it, I use for setting my under eye, and this brush without the tape, I use it to apply highlighter to my face, and you can see it's very dirty, but that is okay. Another Real Techniques brush. This is their fluffy powder brush. I use it to set my face with powder. I've used it to apply blush in the past. I've used it for contour. Like I said, there are no rules, rhymes, reasons with makeup brushes or even makeup. You just do whatever works best, but this is what I prefer to use powder for. And this is a really, really old MAC eyeshadow brush. It's very fluffy and soft. I will use this to apply my inner corner highlight or my brow bone highlight. Moving on to some of the beauty tools I use. This is my Wet n Wild Mega Volume Mascara in Black. This is my ColourPop Mascara in Black. I really like this mascara. It makes your lashes very long and voluminous, but the only thing I would say about it is the formula is a bit too wet. So I tend to get a lot of fallout under my under eyes, but a trick I use is to apply a non-waterproof mascara like this one and set it with a waterproof mascara like this one. Next I have my e.l.f. Clear Brow and Lash Mascara. This is my Too Faced Born This Way Naturally Radiant Concealer. I use the color Light Medium. Now this is my very dirty beauty blender sponge that needs to be thrown away. Next I have a pair of tweezers. These are just a generic pair of tweezers I got from Kroger. Then I have had these pair of tweezers for the longest time. I think they were my mom's and she gave them to me when I started struggling with hirsutism. So these are just really, really old tweezers. I have no idea where they're from, but you can get tweezers anywhere, Walmart, Target. Next, I have my Milani Liquid Eyeliner in the color black. Next, I have my Tweezerman Eyelash Curler, which I'm so sorry, my products are so dirty. That's how you know they're very well used, and this one's covered in mascara, so I am so sorry. And last but not least, I have my e.l.f. little, pencil sharpener. Moving on to my makeup palettes that I have, I'll start with my Too Faced Sweet Peach palette. This is pretty self-explanatory. It's very popular. It smells like peaches, which is great. I use this all the time. I have my Naked 2 by Urban Decay, which is also very well used and loved. And then I have my Too Faced Natural Eyes palette. See if I can get it open. I just got this for Christmas, so I'm still kind of working on using it, kind of playing with it, but this color right here is my favorite. It is called Push Up. So this is the first set of drawers that I have for my makeup, and I won't go through everything because that's going to take a super, super long time, but I'll just go through it kind of briefly. So this top drawer, I just have small palettes. I have Sonia Kashuk, I have Pixie, I have NYX, and I have Wet n Wild. So these are just some tiny little palettes that I like to use. This next drawer is kind of miscellaneous. I have some ColourPop liquid shimmery eyeshadow. I have my Steal a Kitten, which I love, 2 eyeshadow pencils from Ulta, and just a variety of things, really. This next drawer is my prized possession, as I call it. These are all my ColourPop shadows. And in the next drawer, this is my face makeup. So I have my Becca kind of loose powder, setting powder. I have a Milani bronzer, which I love. I have the Kat Von D Locket Tattoo Foundation, and I have an e.l.f. foundation. And then back here is my Bare Minerals powder foundation. And the bottom drawer is also kind of miscellaneous, but it's miscellaneous cheek products. So I have some Wet n Wild blushes. I have my Makeup Revolution highlighter that I love. I have some ColourPop highlighters and blushes. And then my Jaclyn Hill. This is the second set of drawers I have. So starting on the top here, this is my California Sun Glow bronzer little thing that I got. I got this on a cruise, so I don't think they sell it anywhere other than Carnival cruise ships, but I absolutely love this stuff. It comes in this little clay pot, which I love, and maybe sometime I'll use it in a video. Now, this Lush product, I'm not sure what it's called, but it is in the shape of a heart. And what it is, it's a kind of a shimmer body butter, so you rub it all over yourself and it gives you a very shimmery glow, and it smells really good. I can't really describe the smell, but I absolutely love it. Starting off on the top drawer, these are just some tools that I have. So I have some false lashes, I have some scissors to cut false lashes, I have a random kind of gel eyeliner and some glue and extra eyeliner, my lip scrub, which I adore. This drawer is all my brushes, so just extra brushes that I reach for. These is basically my whole brush collection, minus the ones that I showed you that were in my makeup bag. And on the bottom is all my lip products. So as you can see, I have a bunch of Milani lip glosses. I have some lip scents, lip products, which I love. I have a ColourPop liquid red lipstick, which is so fierce, so sexy. I love this stuff. And I have a Winky Luxe lipstick that you guys have seen, and this is actually really cool. So Merle Norman did my makeup for my wedding, and on my wedding day they gave me samples of the lipstick and lip gloss that I wore. So these are just the little samples, and I use them very sparingly because they are just a very special memory. Coming back into the beauty closet, I have some Healthy Hair, Skin, and Nails pills, and then I have some It Works Healthy Hair, Skin, and Nails pills, some basic cotton rounds that I got from Target, and my husband was so sweet and picked up the Garnier Skin Active Micellar Makeup Removing Towelettes for me. I keep them upside down just to keep them moist. There's this little flower teddy bear that I got from my husband for Valentine's Day. And then we have the nail section. So this container I got from my husband's grandmother, and I love it. So in here I keep some nail clippers and some cuticle pushers, so just basic things like that. I have some nail files that are disposable. You just use them once and throw them away. I love those. Next, I have this giant container, and this just keeps all my nail polishes. I have a variety, mostly Essie, but I have Essie, I have OPI, and China Glaze in there. If you guys want a nail polish video, I'd be happy to do that, but for the sake of time. And then I just have some basic strengthening nail polish remover back there. And this, these are all the brushes that are either too big for the makeup bag or too big to put in the little drawer. So I have some It Cosmetics big powder fluffy brushes. I have an Eco Tools buffer brush. I have a Jaclyn Hill highlighter brush. Some more Real Techniques brushes. And this mirror my sister's best friend got me for my bridal shower, and I love it. So thank you, Brie. And then back there is a perfume set that I got for Christmas. It's basically empty, but I just like the container. Moving on to the big purple drawer, I just have pads and tampons up here. You guys really don't need to see that. This, I just have little hair accessories. So I have little hair clips. I have this beautiful hair clip that I got from Hawaii. This is from Francesca's. And just little hair accessories, really. Oops. Push that back in. In the bottom, I just have skincare products. So I have a skincare sample. I have some Clean and Clear Versagel 10. I have some razor burn cream. These are just essential oils in here. I have some sheet masks and just little things like that. So this, I just keep some hair products in. I have all my hair ties right here. Next, I have some little hair elastics and bobby pins and just little things to style my hair with. And on the bottom is just random contact solutions, some extra contacts, and contact cases. And last but not least, I just have random skincare products right here. So I have some Body Boost Firming Cream from Pure Romance, love it. I have my Ion Finishing Hairspray. I have Love Beauty and Planet Dry Shampoo. I have brush cleanser. I have Pretty as a Peach lotion from Bath and Body Works. My Nair stuff, you guys have seen me use that. And this I love. So this is Sally Hansen's Airbrush Legs. So, and what it does, it is basically foundation for your legs and body. I use this all the time during the summer when I'm wearing a skirt or shorts or something that's gonna be revealing my legs. And my husband is super, super sweet and just bought me some Burt's Bees facial cleanser, and it's sensitive because I have very sensitive skin, and I can't wait to use this. I'm waiting to use up my current face wash. That is my makeup collection, organization, and storage video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more organization and storage videos, please let me know. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Give this video a big thumbs up, and don't forget to leave a comment below. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day. Bye!